Something I only know is the Dark Presence held my wife captive and used her to make me write a horror story that came true.
I'll bring her back.
Some part of me had been aware enough to write my escape into the story.
Alan?
I saved Alice and wrote a better ending for the story. But not without a price. I was trapped somewhere in the dark place, a strange zone somewhere beyond our world.
It's not a lake. It's an ocean.
After the completion of any difficult undertaking, there are mixed emotions. Accomplishment and relief. Sadness, depression. For a while, everything was about the work. Like an illness, it consumed you, changed you. You locked yourself away from the world to do it, and now you need to recover. Learn to live without it. Find a way to crack open the door and let the light back in. I knew this place. It was familiar, but wrong somehow.
Welcome to the
Everything had a surreal, dreamlike quality.
I can't believe it.
I had a disturbing feeling of déjà vu. I had no idea why I was here or where I had been before this moment, but something was waiting for me at the back of the diner.
I could really use a tune right now. Number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious?
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Don't go in there, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
Alan, listen to me. Go no deeper.
What?
Focus. You're losing yourself. I will try to help the best I can. But it's up to you. Find a better point of contact.
What do you mean?
I cannot hear you. Please, you're the one making all this happen. Concentrate. This is what's happening.
Nightmares. Too deep. Can't take the pressure. It's too much.
Suddenly, Wake found himself face to face with himself.
At the sight of myself, the dream suddenly became lucid. The dark place. That's where I was.
You will need weapons. It's not the light itself, but what it represents. You will need it. This is not a gun. It is a tool in a logical process of elimination. Be careful. I will try to find a better point of contact.
I didn't understand Zane's message. And knowing where I was didn't fix anything. Something had gone wrong after I had finished departure. What the hell was that?
Day had become night. The diner had become deserted. Then the door was smashed off its hinges and Wake had to fight for his life.
Don't forget your lunchbox.
Didn't belong here. I knew it was my writing, but the words were jumbled, dreamlike fragments. Reloading frantically, the rounds of slippery stone was thrown away from the tent.
The bed looked inviting,
but it was just the radio.
I had to go on.
She was startled by the phone. The GPS system was working. I hadn't expected that. Hello?
I'm trying to reach you. Can you hear me? Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Listen, I can help you, but you're drifting deeper. I can't reach you. You must come to me. I can't maintain the connection. Use the words. Follow the signal.
It made no sense for the GPS system to work. I doubted any satellite was in range here. These were alien skies, but it was guiding me towards something. Towards Zane? Something had shifted again. The dark place was playing tricks on me. It wouldn't stay still.
The town itself turned against Wake. Cars flew toward him.
Everything I saw was familiar, and yet it wasn't.
Hello?
I cannot keep up. You're going too deep. I will try to guide you. Follow the signal.
I'm trying!
You must face yourself. Follow me.
Oh!
The GPS system was supposed to lead me to Zane, but the shifts were interfering with it. I had to keep trying. I wouldn't survive alone. The changes were becoming more violent. The street wasn't so much ripped apart as it was missing. Like some great hand had reached down and scooped it up. Everything felt erratic, unstable.
are you? Look, I'm trying to follow your goddamn signal.
The dark place is playing tricks on you. You're still going deep. I'm trying to guide you, but it's hard.
What is this?
I can help you if you just stop sinking.
What? This is bullshit.
It's happening again. Brace yourself.
I was running after Zane, and he was telling me I was going too deep. It was ridiculous, but I was more scared than amused. I felt like I was being hindered by an unseen force in ways I couldn't fight. All I could do was keep going.
See Barry.
Look, wake. Maybe that's him. That's the way to the chopper.
I remembered this. This happened before we found Barry. Find the key to get the door open. Severe. I wasn't sure if the place got bigger or I got smaller. The signal was going haywire. I would have to find my way out of here on my own.
Thank you.
Zane left me a page. He was trying to help me.
Yowza!
Barry?
Hey, bestseller! Looking good!
You're not real.
Well, no shit. What gave me away? What, the see-through thing? I'm a figment of your imagination, just like pretty much everything else you see here. Maybe even you.
That's insane.
Yeah, you're right. Everything that happened before made perfect sense, but this is insane. Good catch, Al.
Okay. Okay, look, I gotta get going. The GPS...
The GPS, yeah, I know. Follow the signal. Got it. So, anywho, I'm here to help you. The thing is, you get a grip, alright?
You nag the way the real Barry does. You know that?
Well, hey, you know, be fair. It's not my fault you think I'm annoying.
I don't think you're annoying.
Al, baby, relax. It's cool. Just try to stay on the ball here. You need to do what Zane tells you. He's been here for ages. He's like the expert.
I think the signal's pointing
anyway,
towards that
this
thing in the distance.
Is insane. Yeah, that'd be the Biltmore sawmill.
How the hell do you know that?
I don't know anything you don't. So why don't you ask yourself that? Huh? Maybe you saw a sign for it back in the real world. Or maybe it's the sawmill, because I said it's the sawmill, and now you can't get it out of your head.
Fantastic.
Yeah, it sure is giving me a headache. Or is that your headache? Do you have a headache?
Barry.
Cross here. I'm thinking the solution probably has something to do with those words.
Really? You think?
Yeah! You should probably use that.
Your insight is staggering.
Aw, I know.
That's horseshit.
Al? I'm not saying anything you haven't come up with first. Big Mint, remember?
This kind of thing could drive a man insane.
No! This is great! And it's probably therapeutic for you, too!
Wake's own words littering the landscape. His books common and discarded. His feet, hardbacks, paperbacks, turned against him. Trash. Just cheap trash.
I had seen weird transmissions of myself before, but not like this. The version of myself I saw now sounded insane, like a demented storyteller who was out to torment and destroy.
Shook. Streetlights pushed themselves up to the ground, flickering madly and spitting sparks.
In the shadows, Wake saw far too many figures advancing eerily, already tasting the kill.
Okay, this is just too weird. You're weird.
Barry, is all this really coming out of my head?
It's just the way this place is, Al. All that random stuff in your head? You need to get that door open before you can get into the warehouse. That's the way forward.
If I'm making this up, why is it so complicated?
Because you're a complicated man, and no one understands
you.
But I'm talking...
Barry.
Thank you.
What are you up to? I thought this was my side of the bed.
He entered the trap, surrounded by enemies. Wake had nowhere to run.
I'm so sick of you!
That's never a good sound, is it?
No. No, it isn't. You're not even really there.
Well, my allergies are definitely... Achoo! See? Allergies.
Thank you.
downstairs. We don't have time for Alan.
I knew she was coming out of here, but she still made my heart ache. I had saved Alice. I wasn't even sure when that happened. Was it days ago? Weeks? Longer? I had no way of knowing.
Hey, lover. Come here. I've got something for you.
I could only hope that Alice was all right. I didn't know what happened to her after she left the dark place.
Zane? Is that you?
Hey, hold that pose. That was a good one.
Like this?
Yeah, but smile a little more. No, that's too much. You want to look mysterious. Maybe a little tough. You know how people go for those dangerous bad...
Zane, how do I get out of here?
That's what you face. That's you, even as we speak.
Darkness. Darkness coming! Swept him away. Lost. He knew. He knew! He couldn't hold on. He knew there was no way out.
Oh! No, I'm right here,
oh,
Zane.
I'm going wrong.
That's not me, it's just...
Wrong.
I don't know, an echo, a hallucination, the dark presence.
No, the dark presence is not responsible for this. You are making this happen. You're trapped in your own nightmares. You're fighting yourself.
Wake didn't understand it. He would never make it. He would never wake up. He'd get swallowed up in the rising tide of darkness. It was coming. It was coming.
Shut up!
No! Alan, you must be.
Swept away by the gathering insanity. Zane was gone! Wake could feel the pressure, gnawing at his mind. The darkness wasn't so bad. It was in him. He felt it. He knew the voice spoke the truth. It was just too hard to think. He can't... couldn't make sense of it. Couldn't... He wanted to go with the flow. Stop thinking and just let go.
Thank you.
It's all in your head. You've been making it up. Really, Wayne. Come on. Your delusions are your delusions.
Things really matter.